ScoopOnScoop is sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a Bachelor's in Information Technology and Computer Science, Arts and Science in Education, International Relations and Diplomatic Studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro with branches in Bara, Kampala and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation.
Today it's a Friday. I love to shout that out every Friday. Well, before we even get into anything, I read in the Kampala Sun that what's her name? Our former Miss Uganda Bizzu moves around with her crown in her bag. I was like, Wanji, Bizzu. Honestly speaking, you walk around the streets of Kampala with your crown, a crown that probably cost Brenda Nanyonjo something like 20k. In your mind, you believe since you became Miss Uganda, you done made it in life. What the hell is wrong with these Ugandan chicks? Yeah, Soma, do you have a day job? Do you need your collar? I mean, it baffles me. And this chick has lived her life like this. The past years, she attends functions and pulls out her tiara. She's like, I was Miss Uganda. People call ya. I'm just saying, but it's not my place. If she believes she's that beautiful, who am I to say anything? It's a Friday. My name is Tina and Davida Kusawaya Bizzu. The only thing you can take away from her to snap her back into reality, move back in. But let's get delving into what's happening in Celebrityville. My name is Tina. Like I said, it's Scoop on Scoop. Ykee Benda. What? You see, I have to appreciate the Ugandan community for making a celebrity really a celebrity. So Ykee Benda got down on one knee, yes, and he popped the question. He proposed to his chick. Why is this bothering me? Of course, I went to social media. Everybody was putting the photos up. Ykee dressed in Ebrian's clothes. I know could Zayo at any one moment. Looking very uncomfortable, but he had to make the moment. And yes, it has gone viral, but my questions are different, you know? It's a good thing when a young gentleman decides to step forward and ask for responsibility and be given responsibility. But Ykee Benda of all people. Ykee, you graduated, let me see, like what, 2 years ago or a year ago? Your musical career hasn't pretty much taken off because, I mean, we're still singing to Farmer because Shiba was on it and she was pretty much naked and raunchy and saucy in every way. And apart from that, what else is going for you? It's just a question. Mbuza. So you asked someone's daughter for her hand in marriage. What were you asking for meanwhile? Was it a hand in marriage, a hand in courtship, a hand in just mgabanaka zigoke mbademu, longer and much better? Wait, I doubt you can even pay your rent at this particular moment. It's not a bad thing. You know, I'm happy. But in Africa, TIA, this is Africa. You, a poor man's child, does not go down and begin asking for someone else's child's hand in marriage. Techikwa atagana. It's wrong. Maybe if you're a rich kid, you can pull that crap off. But a poor child? No. Kuba msaja watu, I'm looking at all the variables that are going to change for you in your life, and I just can't believe you did this. It's like the dumbest thing that you've done. 3 songs out before you know which chick is going to be pregnant, and then you're going to be forced, you're going to be doing songs like Unique for the rest of your life. You'll be an upcoming artist. Do you want to end up being like Biboyo? Do you want to end up being like Michael Rose? That is where you're headed to. You should have given yourself time to grow as a person. But then also these girls. My dear sister, oh, let me break it down for you. Right now it's so cool when your man passes by, everybody's like, that's why Ykee Benda. He's gone down on one knee and popped the question, given you a very cheap ring at that. You think that is what it's always going to be? You think this guy can sustain you for the next, what, 20 years? I may be wrong. But honestly, remember, whenever I'm such a gendo, you just look at him. Anyway, it's not my place to ask, but this is the part where we say kongs. Ready band on the NC, a kubiono. Ash! Oh my, you know when. Good! Anyway, like I was saying, so for you to say that Elvis sekyanzi is broke, nah, it doesn't work for me. Honestly, it does not work for me because how
Then I try to get conspiracies in my mind. I'm like, oh, hold up. Maybe Elvis is selling off and liquidating all his assets to help Daddy Dearest. Because Daddy Dearest
just lost a bunch of things. But he only lost the TV station. Why does everyone make it sound like when he lost the TV station, he lost his entire life? Nah. You people are like, to like it out or query him. But you see, these fingers, tezenkana for a reason. I may be here saying this guy is broke, and yet his brokenness is in billions. Like probably 2 billion shillings. That's when he's broke. Because he's usually used to having 20 bill. You cannot begin comparing your brokenness to his brokenness. So I don't think these guys are broke. Probably they're getting out of business to go and do something else. Because, but also them, their choice of businesses is just has been a little bit disturbing. But let's wish them the best. All I know is that I don't think they can really go broke. They can. Because, I mean, we're still asking ourselves what happened to Michael Ezra. Someone told me he's being housed by one of the rich folk here. After he told us he was a CIA agent who had come, and then when he left, he had gone undercover. Sekyanzi, maybe you need to look for people like Ezra and ask them, how stupid were you to lose all of it? Because I haven't. Honestly speaking, Michael Ezra, what the hell? You had money. You wanted to at one time buy a football club, and now you're sleeping in someone's boys' quarters? Wow! Is all I can say, but hey, maybe like I said, even Ezra may be broke, but Tata Buliraku board. But you know what? Ugandan chicks just amaze me. So, Bizzu comes out and the headline of her grill is, "I am beautiful will be written on my grill."
Girl, bye.
Honeymoon, bye, bye. Bye, bye.
This chick has wanted, her entire life she has wanted Ugandans to actually tell her she's beautiful.
You have tried. Kampala-san, thank you for giving her the headline, because I know she begged for it. But we are still going to sit here and say you are ugly. We jumped. Every time you find Bizzu, she's trying so hard to enforce it on us Ugandans to say she is beautiful. She walks around with her crown in her bag. I think whenever she stops, she's like, I am beautiful. Do you see my crown? I won't miss Uganda. Girl, bye. You are not. You're not going to be now like this. I mean, it's been years past and Ugandans have still said you're ugly. You are ugly. Just deal with it. And it's not bad to be ugly. There could be nice things about being ugly. I don't know. I'm trying to look for the nice things about you, Bizzu, and I have failed. Because I wish for a minute you'd eaten some humble pie, kept your goofus somewhere, and you won Miss Uganda, who were fraudulently given you as a Miss Uganda. Uganda is still, by the way, very pissed off. That was very rigged. But hide your goofus somewhere. To call your gulaba. We don't want to see you. Bizzu, let me ask. If you say you're beautiful, what will Ella say? If you're saying you're beautiful, because na Ella, we have question marks. We have very many question marks. We're not sure if she's pretty, if she's congested, if she's... You know how for the time Ella looks like she's constipated? Like, I never quite... I know, I can't. I just don't know how to... But... So, Bizzu, if you say you're beautiful, what is Fabiola going to say? Because you can see she's beautiful. There's nothing in her head, but she's beautiful. What will she say if you're saying you're beautiful? I'm just asking. You know what? Bizzu admit has, it has finally made sense to me. You don't have friends. All the wololos around you, the people around you, especially Brenda Nanyonjo, Bona! Tell them to leave you because they clearly don't want anything nice for you. They have been lying to you for a very long time. You are not that beautiful. Right? This is me being polite. I mean, just because some random tourist both met you in a bar on one of those drunken nights when you didn't have much to do with your life as usual, and they told you you're beautiful, you moved on, you stepped on everything in this world and you said you're beautiful. No, random tourist left random country. He was told the country he's going to is running free and wild with nature, chimpanzees, apes. And before he could make it to the park, he passed by some bar. There you are. You are amazing. You were running wild and free, like the nature they told him.
I got you messed up. You should come talk to Shaban Senyange. He'll help you use your look more. I mean, Uganda, the Wildlife Authority could use a face like yours. Think about it. Other than running around telling the world you're beautiful with an empty pass.
Hey! That's been my crazy week. For all of you who just want to know where I'm getting all this nonsense from, it's in my head, just in my head. Oh yeah, and I wanted to send shout outs. I know it's a Friday, I'm not supposed to send shout outs but it's my show. Let me do what I want. I want to shout out to Frank Rukundo, this guy. Maybe I can't call him a wololo. He watches all the time. He's in Canada and he told me, you are in what? Big Brother.
Wow.
I wanted to actually ask, why is it everyone who leaves Big Brother, they... Anyway, thank you for watching the show. Much, much love. I promise I'll send you out shout-outs. I have. And I'd like to send shout-outs to all those useless people abroad. Yes, I'm saying it. There's some guy, they sent me screenshots of some idiot called Simania. Oba mumu jukira. Oba he was chameleons wololo. Video brown something. And then he had some other dark-skinned, ugly thing. His girlfriend, Nayadia, Yoba, Mabanda, Uganda. Feng Feng has really made way for everyone to think they're a celebrity. Naye Temulina, Kemulina, Temutua Samira, Tuliba Kowu, and I wish you a good Friday. But besides that, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. You can also get me on Facebook. That's the Scoop on Scoop Facebook page. Or YouTube for those who want to binge watch. It's a long weekend. I've had fun with you this week. Next week could be even much saucier. We're going to be salty. I wanted to know what that coming of a guy throwing salt on food means. That would be my weekend hustle. For now though, I'm out. Peace.
ScoopOnScoop was sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a bachelor's in information technology and computer science, arts and science in education, international relations, and diplomatic studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro, with branches in Barra, Kampala, and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation.